Thank you, Bishop, on this beautiful feast of St. John Vianney, to have the opportunity to share a few words with all of you about vocations. As the bishop said, I was privileged to be in that exhilarating place of campus ministry at Stony Brook for the past 3 years. And as Father Duffy knows well from his time at LIU Post, it's a gift to be able to spend time with young people who are bright, intelligent, and searching for meaning and purpose in life. I would simply hold out to all of us this morning a few things that I picked up on in my time at Stony Brook. The first is a reminder of the culture in which we propose vocations to our young people, be they to marriage, priesthood, religious life. Our culture celebrates the idea of randomness. It's moved away from a sense of purpose in life. You know this well. We read it in the papers, we hear it on television, that we're called to determine ourselves, that we create truth, that we determine reality. And first and foremost, as a chaplain for all of us in the faith, it's a preaching of Jesus Christ, who is the way, the truth, and the life. And the most basic and fundamental of things handed down over the centuries, that we are created in God's image and likeness, and created with a purpose, a call in life. When I found students who came upon that great truth, who knew it in their hearts, from their high schools they attended, from the families they grew up in, it was a gift. Because you could begin to move with them from this very basic truth that I'm made with a purpose, to beginning to discern the call, that the one who made me calls me to a special way of living life. Again, be it to marriage, to priesthood, to religious life. And then to walk with those students, to spend time with them, to see their prayer life unfold, to hear what the Lord was speaking to them, a gift. I had the chance, the opportunity in my time at Stony Brook to write letters of recommendation for four men now studying for priesthood, for our diocese, for New York, the Archdiocese, for the Archdiocese of Hartford, and we gave a gift to Bishop Koenig, also the Diocese of Wilmington now too in Delaware. For those opportunities to write the letters, for the countless conversations that I had with students searching, the gift to be able to again see and remind them of this call. The one who created you has called you, and he will be with you and walk with you. The bishop in the past number of months has created what's now a vocation promotion and recruitment team. It builds on the good work of Father Sean Magaldi, our current vocation director, and the previous vocation directors, Father Joe Fitzgerald, Father Brian Barr, Father Thomas Coogan, and Father Thomas Harold, and Monsignor Bill Bishop Koenig, and all those before. The idea of this team, led by Father Rob Ketchum and Father Michael Duffy, Father John Crozier, Father Matt Brown, is simply to promote that culture of vocations, to remind us all of that most basic thing, that we're created by love, for love, through love, and that all of us are called by the one who made us into a beautiful way of living life with the Lord, and that some are called to the priestly call, as St. John Vianney reminds us this day, a life of sacrificial love, of pouring ourselves out, of living the model that Jesus himself has taught us, to love others as he has loved us. This team, led by, again, Father Ketchum, will in the coming months just simply promote events, opportunities to gather together, most especially at holy hours, with the Lord in the Blessed Sacrament, to pray, to beseech the Lord for vocations, that people, young people, hear that beautiful reminder that they're loved, that they're created, and that they're called. So I simply hold those points out to all of you this day, and I would invite you to join with that vocation promotion and recruitment team in your own ways, at home, as you go about your day. First, to preach Jesus Christ as the way, the truth, and the life, to speak up in the midst of all the craziness at times of what we hear, that randomness that the world promotes, to say, no, there is the Lord who shows us life, and that this Lord calls us, and to remind young people of that, that life isn't simply what I want to do, but it's lived in response to what God's will is for me. And then most especially to pray. Pray that young people have the courage to hear and to respond to the Lord who calls them, the Lord who has loved them. May St. John Vianney raise up for us here and across the globe many vocations to priesthood, and may he encourage young people always to respond generously to the Lord who calls them.